Of any California state Senate candidate, Democrat or Republican. On Tuesday's election. Everybody welcome Mark Leno. Let's hear you say Mark Leno!
Francisco! Thank you for being here. Thank you for your peaceful, nonviolent protest of the passage of Proposition 8, respecting Dr. Martin Luther King and Mahatma Gandhi and Cesar Chavez. We will keep it peaceful. And thank you also for electing Barack Obama president. Now let me tell you what else happened on November 4th. Yes, we came up 4 points short, but we did something much more miraculous. Keep in mind that the identical 14 words of Proposition 8 were before the California voters in March of 2000 in the form of Prop 22, which amended the family code as opposed to changing, revising the Constitution. Prop 8, they say that marriage is between a man and a woman because our Bible tells us so. Wait a second. There is a First Amendment right to everyone's freedom of religion in our democracy, but we don't live in a theocracy. Religion. But no one religious book creates the laws of the land. No Bible, no Torah, no Koran. The holy books of our democracy are the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, and the Bill of Rights. Those are our holy books. Now, they call them what they are. They want a theocracy, not a democracy. Where have they been on social justice issues historically? Now, going back to the late 19th century, when legally and literally women were the property, and in 1920, when we were fighting for women's right to vote, the religious right said, do not do that. The sky will fall. Civilization as we know it will end. They opposed a woman's right to vote, and they lost that battle. 1954, the United States Supreme Court rules that we must integrate our public schools. The religious right fought that and said our Bible tells us that there are more superior human beings than others. They fought the integration of our public schools, and they lost that battle too. 1967, when the Earl Warren U.S. Supreme Court finally ended the ban on interracial marriage. The judge in the Virginia versus Loving case actually said that the ban should stand because the good Lord put different races on different continents for a purpose, so we would not intermarry. They lost that battle too. So the religious right has been on the wrong side of history on every social movement. They're wrong on marriage equality. Loving, devoted same-sex couples have every right to their constitutional guarantee of equal protection under the law. Houses, before you go to the voters, and the proponents of Prop 8 did not follow the Constitution. And that's why the Supreme Court